In this video, we are going to learn how to get over a breakup. Keep in mind that getting over a breakup takes time and patience. If things don't seem to get better with time, remember that you can always turn to friends, family, or even a mental health professional for support.
In the pit of hell, looking across fire, caught fire from the big guns. These is not revolvers, dollars only trees. Future, it ain't a promise, I'ma get stoned.
Step 1. Keep your distance. Even if you and your ex have decided to stay friends, break away completely from each other right after the breakup. This means not seeing each other, not being around his or her family members, no phone calls, no emails, no text messages, no Facebook, and no IMS. Step 2. Organize your space. A breakup can signify a new beginning. Therefore, cleaning and organizing your personal space will leave you feeling refreshed and prepared for the new things to come. A mess can be overwhelming and depressing, and will just add to your stress level. Step 3. Remove painful memory triggers. There are all kinds of things that remind you of your ex's song, a smell, a sound, a place. Having these items around can make it harder for you to recover from a breakup. Remove all of the things. Step 4. Get out and do things. After a relationship ends, it is okay to have some time to yourself at home. Just make sure that you get back out in the world after you have processed your feelings. Make plans, go out with your friends, and have fun. It might seem awkward at first, but it will get easier and it will help you to feel better. Step 5. Beware of rebound relationships. Often people will quickly enter a new relationship following a breakup. This type of relationship is called a rebound relationship. Rebounding may be common, but it is not always a good idea. Consider remaining single until you have fully processed your emotions and gotten over the breakup. Step 6. Continue to take care of yourself. It is common for people to put less effort into self-care after a breakup, but doing so will not help you to feel better. Make sure that you are seeing to your basic needs for mental, physical, and spiritual well-being. Make sure that you are eating well, sleeping enough, making time for relaxation, and getting regular exercise to feel your best. Step 1. Know that the pain you are feeling is normal. After a breakup, it is normal to feel sad, angry, frightened, and other emotions as well. You might be worried that you will end up alone or that you won't be happy again. Just remind yourself that it is normal to feel this way after a breakup and that you need to feel these emotions in order to move on. Step 2. Take a break from your normal routine. It may be necessary for you to take a short break from your normal routine after a relationship ends. Having this time may help you to process your feelings and function better in the long run. Step 3. Allow yourself to grieve the loss of the relationship. The end of a relationship can leave a big hole in your heart, which may require a significant grieving period. Make sure that you give yourself permission to grieve this loss and experience the pain that it causes. Step 4. Surround yourself with supportive people. You want people around you who love you and who will help you feel good about yourself. Surrounding yourself with compassionate, supportive friends and family. Step 5. Find healthy ways to soothe your emotional pain. It may be your first instinct to want to ignore or dull your pain by turning to alcohol, drugs, or food, but these will not provide long-term solutions. Steer clear of these unhealthy methods of dealing with your emotional pain. Step 6. Consider talking to a therapist if the pain becomes too great. Many people are able to recover from a breakup on their own, but this is not possible for everyone. If you are having trouble coping with your emotional pain or if you think you might be depressed as a result of the breakup, get help from a mental health professional as soon as possible. Step 1. Reflect on your relationship. Consider all of the reasons that you and your ex broke up. Thinking about the reasons why the relationship ended can help you understand why you need to move on. You may also be able to avoid making the same mistakes in the future if you can identify areas where you contributed to the demise of the relationship. Step 2. Write about your feelings. Write in a journal or try writing poems. The most important thing is to be honest and don't edit yourself as you go. One of the best results of writing it all down is that sometimes you will be amazed by a sudden insight that comes to you as you are pouring it all out onto paper. Step 3. Deal with your anger. Feelings of anger occur when we feel we have been wronged or there has been unfair treatment. In a situation where you will not contact your ex-partner, the best way to deal with anger alone is to relax. Step 4. Stand by your decision. If the breakup was your decision, keep in mind that focusing on the good times you had with your partner may cause you to forget the reasons why you broke it off. By the same token, try not to second-guess the situation if the decision to end things was not yours. Accept the situation and work on moving forward. Step 5. Remind yourself of your ex's negative traits. Focusing on all of the things that you don't like about your ex can help you to get over the breakup faster. Try making a list of all of the things your ex did that you did not like. For example, maybe your ex often burped loudly after dinner, or made plans without you, or forgot your birthday. List every little thing that bothered you about your ex. Step 6. Consider the reasons why you are better off without your ex. In addition to reminding yourself of everything that bothered you about your ex, you can also benefit from thinking about the positives to your breakup. Make another list of all of the reasons why you are better off without your ex.